Hi, everybody. So welcome to the Bay of Naples, right behind me. So we've got people from all over the country today, which is really great. We're really excited to you. When we sent out the invitation, we wrote this little teaser, kind of giving you a picture of really what we're going to do today. It's a little different from what we've done in the past. Again, so many of you know the Bay of Naples and the Amalfi Coast. For those that haven't been there or have been there, please use the chat. Let us know. We always, you know, love whatever information you can give us. I guess this is more than 50 webinars. We were taking a look. I think some of you have been to almost all of them, which is just so exciting for us. It's been wonderful to see business starting to come back. A lot of you guys are starting to get really busy, and we understand that. One thing is that if everyone could just turn off your microphones, just so that when the speakers are talking, that everyone can hear them and there's no background noise, that would be great. So again, here we are in the Bay of Naples. I'm gonna do my typical daily weather report. Summer has definitely arrived. We'll be meeting with some people in Naples. It's hot. It's now about 90 degrees, and tonight it's gonna drop to about 74, very balmy. I took a look at the forecast this week. It's going to be sunny every day and upper 80s, nights in the low 70s. And as we're going to be on the water, I thought it was important to also tell you what the water temperature was going to be. So generally speaking, this time of year through September, the water temperature is in the upper 70s, low 80s. So just unbelievably great swimming weather. So we've got a few guests with us today. So I wanted to just go through that. So the first person that you're gonna meet is a dear friend, Susan Van Allen. Some of you may know her as the author of 100 Places in Italy Every Woman Should Go. Definitely a good read. Susan grew up in New Jersey. Her maternal grandparents were Italian, immigrated to America from Southern Italy. She's written for National Geographic, Town and Country, Tastes of Italy. You may have heard her on NPR. And Susan was a writer for a show that I just loved, and many of you, I'm sure, have seen, Everyone Loves Raymond. And Susan introduced me to the ruins of a home just outside of Pompeii that belonged to Nero's second wife, Sabina Poppea. And she's going to walk us through the ruins of this unbelievable house. We're also going to meet Jessica Rago. Jessica's an American who's lucky enough to have lived in Italy for over 30 years. She's going to take us to an area just outside of Naples, an ancient city of Baia, which was the exclusive playground of rich and powerful Romans. The ancient aristocracy of that time, they ended up ultimately being submerged, and now you can actually go there, see it through glass bottom boats or snorkeling or scuba diving, and Jessica's gonna explain more about that. And we're gonna take you out on some boats, because I think that's gonna be an important part of maybe the next 2 years. We're always asked to provide information about sailing along the coast. And sometimes it's just for a day trip, and sometimes it's for 3 or 4 days. So today what we want to do is we want to take you on to some boats, sailboats, catamarans, motor yachts, and show you what it's like to actually sleep on some of these wonderful boats. And Johnny and I both feel that this is an unbelievable, unique way to spend time in the area with family and friends, and considering social distancing and traveling in little pods, I think this is like the perfect way to experience the Amalfi Coast. And you know, you'd be surprised at how that it's at prices that really aren't prohibitive, considering if you're going with a group of people and you need two or three rooms and you're staying even in a deluxe hotel, as you all know, it adds up and it's really approaching an experience that I think is bar none, very, very unique. So we've got a lot of ground to cover today. Let me pass this over to Johnny. Welcome everybody. We're thrilled to see you here. And Johnny, take it away.
Thank you very much, Tom. And thank you to Maria Rosaria that is waiting on the boat. And they are already on a swimming kind of fit. So we hope that we're going to enjoy the boat inspection and also what we're going to show on the next videos. So let me go to the share my screen so you can see, and I hope that everybody can see the screen. Everybody sees it, okay? So here where we are on the Bay of Naples and the Oplontis Villa, which is, as Tom said, was the residence of the Nero's wife Poppea. And you will be amazed to see this villa and all the explanation that Susan will be telling us regarding this fantastic location. So let's see where is located the area that we are talking. So Italy, everybody knows the shape of Italy, the area of Campania, the region where Naples is located. And this on red is the area of Naples that we can show you. And Oplontis Villa, as you can see, is here very close to Pompeii and below, obviously, the Vesuvius that create a big problem with the eruption that cover the entire area and the Pompeii area. So let's not talk more. And give the microphone to Susan to explain what is this beautiful location. Susan, it's for you.
Buongiorno. Thank you for coming, everyone. I'm thrilled to introduce you to this Oplontis villa that I discovered when I was writing my book, 100 Places in Italy Every Woman Should Go. They said, well, you have to go to Oplontis, which is next to Pompeii. I mean, a 10-minute drive, 4 minutes on the Circumvesuviana train. And I had never heard of it. And it's just been open to the public since 1988. And because it was excavated late, the frescoes are just amazing, the colors. So should we go on to the video?
Yes, there you go.
Okay. Okay, great. So you could see where it's located on the coast. Now, you don't get that when you approach it because there's a big modern, not a big, but a modern town around it. But it used to sit on a bluff overlooking the sea. And it was part of this whole chain of villas that stretched from Herculaneum down to Stabia. And they were called Ultium Villas because the Romans had this way of leisure where they would study and have banquets and stroll around the pools. And it was like the Hamptons of its day, this place. I mean, Pompeii was the port town where they would go for the brothels and that kind of activity. But Oplontis was, if you were in the know, if you knew the right people, you could go to this incredible villa and we could show it, you could run the video and show it what you get to see when you look when you come inside. It would be good to have a driver. I see that comments. I mean, you could go from Sorrento in about a half an hour. Here's the layout. Look at that pool. That was an amazing part of the entertainments. This is the big entrance hall, as you could see. I mean, a guide will tell you that the colors that they used were showed how rich they were. If you could get these golds and the cinnabar reds, and then you'll see further on the Egyptian blues. when you walk in, the contrast from coming in from this kind of dull town to this villa is incredible. And this shows you the work that was done to restore it. I mean, the walls were just in pieces because it was covered in hot lava. And there are about 99 rooms now that you can see. Oh, here's some of that beautiful, beautiful blue. And the fun thing about it is to imagine the hostess of the parties there, who it is believed to be Empress Poppea Sabina, who was the wife of crazy Emperor Nero, and she matched him in her unusualness. This was the kitchen area, that she loved her beauty so much she needed to be bathed in the milk of 500 asses, so they said. And she was sexually adventurous and crazy, and you just get this whole great stories. Her name was found on these many amphora that were found in Oplontis, and actually even next door to it. It was a small, like, thriving community, more like a little town in the Hamptons, where they also shipped off wine and garum. This is one of the many dining rooms that are there. All the frescoes would inspire awe and also great conversation about conquering the lands and the great times of the empire. And where we're coming up for a close-up, you could see the beautiful, I mean, they got the best artists here. There is a famous bowl of quinces in a glass bowl from this, that you'll see on all the postcards from Oplontis. You just can't believe that this is actually a fresco, and that was painted over 2000 years ago, and that you get to see it in this place, and you get to see it without crowds. Whereas Pompeii on a given day, on its busy days, will have 14,000 people traipsing through it. Here, top day, about 100. These are the frescoes that were by the pool. So you could imagine strolling around, you know, in togas. And there were these beautiful frescoes that matched the beautiful gardens and the marble statues that were around them. And they would have birds and plants, and it all kind of blended together in this beautiful light. I mean, it was the place where they had so much fun. And
Susan, how long does a visit there generally take?
Yeah, I would say, you know, you could feel very satisfied spending an hour there. So you take the half hour trip from Sorrento, you spend an hour there, and then you could go to lunch and, you know, by a winery by Mount Vesuvius, and then get back on the boat. Mm-hmm. There was a lot of marble used here too, to tell about their conquests, you know, like, well, we got this from North Africa, we got this from Greece, Romans are great, right before the fall, you know. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think that's a good show of it. All these, it's fun that the frescoes are so, show all the different styles. If you go with guides, you can see all the different styles of artwork, and these have tiny little birds on them that match the birds that were flying around. It's very beautiful.
And as I understand it, she passed away before the eruption of Pompeii.
Oh, Pompeii. Yes, well, she was stomped upon by her husband, Nero, because he said she was fooling around with gladiators. And it's a gruesome Roman story. But then Nero married a slave who looked like her, but he happened to be male, so he had the slave castrated. But he wanted everyone to show, he wanted everyone to believe that, you know, he still honored Poppea. Mm. His reputation, things like that. This you could see, I mean, there are many little rooms and alcoves, and you can understand how the servants would jump out from places and then start dancing, or have trays of flamingo tongues to serve, or offer massages, or would cut the guests' toenails, or crazy.
And it seems
like
that the size of the villa was over 100,000 square feet.
Right, right. We only see half of it, but now it was amazing. It's just amazing to imagine that day. Yeah, it was completely, it was covered like Herculaneum was, Pompeii was covered in the ash shower. And then there was this lava flow, this hot lava flow that instantly encased it. And that's another reason why it is in such great shape color-wise. It was like freeze-wrapped. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Amazing.
Okay. Thank you very much, Susan. And
now
if you have any question to ask, please use your chat. If there is anybody want to ask a question to Susan, please do so. And otherwise we pass the microphone to Tom that will introduce Jessica. Please, Tom.
Hey, Jessica. Hi, everyone. So Jessica is gonna take us through the underwater park where there's, I mean, I could go on and on about it, but I think that Jessica's gonna do a much better job than I ever will. So Jessica, thank you for taking the time, and we look forward to hearing what you have to say.
Thank you. Hello, everybody. And I welcome you to Pozzuoli and to the Bay of Pozzuoli and our fantastic playground of the Romans in Baia. And there's so much to see, and I would like to introduce you to the sunken archaeology, which is underwater because of a phenomenon called bradycism, which is a volcanic phenomena, which is the vertical movement of the ground, which is caused by the pressure of magma underneath, which it keeps it rising and the ground rising and lowering continuously. And that is why we have so much, we have this enormous archaeological site underwater. It is a vast area, maybe almost as big as the excavation of Pompeii. Still a lot to be discovered. And so the Romans used this area as their place of otium, of their recreational area, also using the thermal energy for their baths, for their natural spas. And so we have this whole area, which was a succession of villas and thermal areas, and also a huge commercial port of Pozzuoli. So there was it's such a large, vast area. There's so much to be seen and a lot that is still being discovered and uncovered.
Jessica, this was just really for the wealthy, right? This is not for the ordinary Roman.
No, along the coast for the wealthy, inland there were normal farming regions and a lot of fantastic production for the Romans, for the aristocracy, for their tables. There was agriculture and inland. Along the coast was for mainly for the aristocracy and wealthier people, and of course their fancy villas, which were, most of the villas were self-sufficient. They had their fish hatcheries and their own agriculture. And so it was important. It was just the perfect place with the perfect climate, also in the winter, and the warmth of the thermal energy to spend long vacations. And so through the centuries, before Christ, the Republican Age, there were Julius Caesar, Marco Tullio, Cicero, and later many emperors, almost all the emperors, Augustus, Tiberius, Claudius, Caligula, Nero, Hadrian, and so on. They were all, they all had their villas here for also for their well-being and their health. And we know that Tiberius probably spent the last years of his life here using the thermal spas as a cure. And we also nowadays, we still use the thermal energy. We have the Roman baths that we can, we still use today with our thermal energy.
And it was so important. It was so important that even 60 Minutes had a show on this one. And this is the video that we're going to show you the first.
I noticed that. I watched that video, and I must say I personally used those
Death Dome,
the Roman baths.
The Bay of Naples, deep into history, exploring the ancient, now sunken city of Baia, once the playground of ancient Rome's elite. He joins underwater archaeologist Barbara Davide and her team as they rediscover ancient Rome's Las Vegas.
Davide's underwater mapping has allowed them to create these 3D models to visualize the more than 400 acres of lavish villas and spas where Emperor Nero and Julius Caesar had homes. Baia was a seaside escape for the ultra-wealthy, with extravagant offerings, including fresh fish from private saltwater ponds.
60 Minutes Plus streams on Paramount Plus.
Situated in the Phlegrean fields on the west side of the Gulf of Naples, the marine protected area of Baia, underwater archaeological park, was established in 2002. Its waters protect an archaeological, geological, and environmental heritage, which is worldwide unique. The structures and buildings from the Roman epoch are still visible, but are presently submerged due to bradyism. Managed by the Superintendence for Cultural and Archaeological Heritage of Naples and Poppea, it can be viewed by authorized diving guides. Villa Protiro and Villa Pisoni are located on the south side of the underwater park. Here, it is possible to admire the intact remains of mosaics made of black and white tiles inlaid in hexagonal design. Across the thermal spa complex, a paved road, originally identified as the legendary Via Herculanea, it is actually a main street at the foot of the ancient hill of Ponte Epitafio. Found within Zone A of the park, the Nymphaeum is a rectangular building with alcoves in the walls. During investigation campaigns, it was possible to reconstruct the wall planimetry of the structure, a magnificent triclinar apsidal hall with four niches for each long side, adorned with precious statues and with an exedra decorated like a cave, where the Odyssey scene was placed. The identification of the statues with the Emperor Claudius' family member and with Dionysus made clear the nature and the chronology of the building. The wall sculptural complex has been explored since 1997 in the Archaeological Museum of the Campi Flegrei in the Aragonese castle of Baia, with an interesting reconstruction of the room. In 2009, synthetic copies of the statues were replaced in situ for the entertainment of diving visitors that can swim within a highly suggestive environment.
Allora, questo questa è la il pavimento la pavimenta.
Oh, in English. In English.
Oh, sorry. This is the pavement, the mosaic pavement of the Villa Protiro, which is so called because it has a double entrance. It's a very large, two-toned, fantastically preserved pavement. And this is one of the many, and there's still other pavements that continue to be found in this area. And the area is very large. So this is the one of the pavements of a large area, a large room.
Now, Jessica, someone was asking if clients can scuba dive this site.
Yes, I was getting that. We can, the scuba divers can go and access this area only with an authorized archaeological guide, a scuba diving guide. And it is not very deep. It's at about 6 meters, from 3 to 6 meters actually underwater. So it's not that deep actually. You don't need any great skills, scuba diving skills. With good visibility in the water, you can see also with a regular mask and snorkel.
And this is the boat that we're gonna see, and the itinerary that we're gonna show is precisely an itinerary done to visit all those locations.
Exactly.
The people
yes.
that you're gonna meet are allowed and have the permit to bring you and your client to the location and visit those submarine parts.
Absolutely, it would be programmed that whatever visits underwater would be with a guide. So they are available with the different scuba diving centers, which we have good contact with. So here we have fantastic, a very recent discovery from 2018, which is a mosaic pavement with these human figures, two of which are two wrestlers. It was also two-toned. And so we can arrange for the divers to visit. Here we have a polychromatic, fantastic pavement. This is in the thermal bath area of the Villa Protiro. And you can see also there's still the perimeters of this area here. And so you see that they have been uncovered for filming, to be filmed, because most of the time they have they're partially covered to be protected. Okay.
Thank you, Jessica.
You're welcome.
And now, Jessica, where are we going? we are going now to show our fleet on location, and we will introduce the people, and Jessica can talk a little bit about those boats.
Okay, we have, this is the Sun Odyssey. I'm not so familiar with these boats, the catamaran and.
Those are the different type of boats.
That these are the different types of boats, which yeah. are
and
our very, very, yeah. very comfortable. And here we have some of these are the an example of an itinerary, which would be with from the port of Naples or from Baia, and to visit, you can read there's the also possibility of extending the area towards Procida, Ischia, and the islands of Ventotene and Ponza, and of course Capri. You can also, there's a possibility to go diving in the Blue Grotto, in the Grotta Azzurra of Capri, which was also a a Roman dining hall, actually, before it was a nymphaeum. We also have the nymphaeum of Claudius, which was also in Baia. So this is here. We have an example of an itinerary leaving from Mergellina Mola.
And now we're gonna see the before getting to Maria Rosaria, and we will show you a little video of the boats that we're gonna show you.
Okay.
Ci togliamo anche i fogli qui. Gianmarco da.
Commento io l'Emerald.
Sì, vai.
Ah, okay. Questa è la motonave.
No, in English.
This is the motor yacht Emerald, and it's a fantastic vintage yacht. It was built in 1957 for a ship owner in Philadelphia. Since then, in 2014, it was renovated with all the new modern navigation technology. It has, it's very, gets good gas mileage. I don't know how you would say that better in English. I guess it's the fuel consumption is very economical. And it has four cabins for eight guests, with each with its own bath, one master, two doubles, and one cabin with bunk bed. Of course, air conditioning, and of course there'd be three crew members in two cabins. The boat itself is equipped with a stabilizer, gyroscopic stabilizer, which keeps it very, very. And it's very, very relaxed and very kickback, relaxing vacation. And you are right there on the sea. And of course, within reach of everything that you want to see above and underwater.
Thanks, Jessica. You know, our goal was really to show you a number of ships that you can just as a suggestion. The wonderful thing about creating an itinerary using a ship is that it's really up to you and the client and us to help you craft this really great experience. So nobody has to stay in one place. We can move around. You can stay. You can keep all your things. We can arrange for cooking on board. Or obviously, we're in the center of some of the greatest food that exists in the world. So at night, they can, you know, your passengers can dock, they can get off the ship, they can go have a lovely dinner, come back, have a relaxing drink on board. So there's a lot of possibilities. And I'm sure all of you, one of the questions you have is, how much does it cost? Come back to us. And I think you're gonna be really pleasantly surprised once we put something together for you. So it's for sure an option that you might never have thought about for your folks, so your clients. So Maria Rosario, we're gonna pass it over to you. Why don't you show us where you are?
Hi, good afternoon, welcome aboard. We are on Emerald boat at the moment. We are outside Sorrento Pier. Okay, and we are this going to show our you the beautiful view.
Oh, this is nice. This is called work. Are you working?
Yeah, it's too hot today.
Oh, good. It sounds looks like very hard work. Yeah, yeah. Okay, Elisa, you look really working very hard. So.
Yeah, good.
But it's a pleasure. It's a pleasure. Yeah.
Thank you. I'm glad we're happy to see you too. So, can you show us a bit of the show us a bit of the boat?
The captain Vittorio.
Hey. Ciao, Vittorio.
We try to show you the cabins. Jessica already explained you the boat, but we try to show you
because okay. We are live from the Emeralds.
Maria Rosaria, Mr. Caras, can you share the screen, please?
Yeah.
Thank you.
We see what you're seeing. So
I see a 1-inch picture. So
you just need to click on the upper right hand side. You'll see an icon that will let you.
Maybe I can show.
It shows speaker view. And that will enlarge the screen.
Could you see
all the boat?
Yes,
we can see.
Oh, okay, nice.
Good. Okay.
This is the living room.
This is the living room. Okay.
There's part of the staff.
So here we have
the television.
TV. Okay. Then we are going in the cabins. The first one is the bigger one, is the master cabin.
With a bigger bathroom.
Okay, you can show it.
Looks very comfortable.
Okay. Yeah, this is the bigger one. Then we have the second cabin, double cabin, with private bathroom.
Perfect.
Okay.
And then we have another one, just over here.
With private bathroom as well. And then the last cabin is a twin bed.
Here we have another bathroom.
Okay. Then we are going up.
Just up and down slowly. Okay, here
is preparing something
for
something.
Great.
And then the cabin with back beds.
Great.
With a private bathroom.
Yes.
Great for a family.
Here there's the bathroom. Okay.
Terrific.
Okay. Here there are staffed cabin. And then
we go up again.
And show you something very
spatial, I think. Okay, where we go?
This is the best view. So can we can go half?
Looks like you may get some rain today.
Sorrento port.
So easy to get on and off the ship.
We also have the frigo bar here. There's a frigo bar. Okay. Let's say that the boat is very comfortable.
Beautiful.
And now we are very happy to introduce you the chef, the owner of the Principe restaurant in Pompeii. It's a Michelin restaurant.
Hello, good morning.
Gianmarco Carli.
Nice to meet you. And we are on board on Emerald today, showing you all we can prepare aboard here. We're launching now a lot of boat experience aboard of fine dining. And we are the only restaurant around the world reproducing the food of the ancient Roman and the custom around the table of the Romans. That's why we did this joint venture with Captain here. Because of the archaeology, the marine archaeology all around Campania. That's why we are proposing also archaeological dinners based on a lot of research that we made with Pompeii ruins during the years. And today we have here on the table to show you an example of an aperitif that we can propose. It's a revisitation in a modern key of all traditional Neapolitan seafood plates. Mm.
You're making me very hungry.
Well, here we can make between 10, 12 or 14 people divided in two or three tables in the deck down or up the stairs where you stayed a few minutes ago. And that's it. We just wait coming you here in Sorrento Coast.
Thank you. That's just you. Beautiful. Just so beautiful. So this is just an example of one of the things that you can do. Johnny, do we have other slides of some of the other ships that we can?
Yeah, I can. We can show the other boats that are on the fleet beside the one that we
the just Emerald, yeah.
visited, the Emerald, and the boat of the fleet are those. Hold on, I share my screen.
So everybody's aware, this is a ship that's, you know, built in the 50s, very classic and beautiful. There's sailboats, there's luxury yachts, and there's lots of rooms. There's a catamaran
The catamaran is the Sun Odyssey and the Leopard. Those are two catamarans, and this is the Sun Odyssey.
That's a sailboat, not a catamaran.
Sorry.
So there's only one catamaran.
Is the Sun Odyssey is this one.
Right.
Is five cabin and 10 berths. You can see some picture. Is a very nice boat, this one too. The Leopard, this is the catamaran with six cabin and 11 berths.
You can see the cabins are 5 cabins each. They have their own bathrooms, full baths.
Yes.
Just plenty of room to explore. Some of the ships have toys on board that you can make, your clients can make use of.
Yeah.
And itineraries that are completely customizable. So
this is the most luxurious one. This is the Adesso. It's 4 cabin and 8 berth. This is really a very, very nice boat. And is this one, the Adesso, the one that you see here. And then you have here the motor yacht Nafisa, which is this one, which really has 5 cabin. And this is the most luxurious one type of boat that can hold up to 10 to 12 people. And you can see it's a very, very nice boat. So those are the boat of our fleet. And as I said, and as we were saying, those can be rented for 1 day or a week or 10 days, whatever, and they can really navigate around the area or even further than the Naples Bay area. So those are our really possibility, and we can create the itinerary that your client may prefer. For some those that likes diving, scuba diving, the archaeology, you have the program that we have shown you on the slide. This one, this is a possibility, but we have other type of itinerary that are available, and we will post on our website all those information for you. And obviously this video is available also within 24 hours in our website or on our YouTube channel, but you know the address.
And okay. If any of you have specific questions about the ships, about arranging for diving on the archaeological sites, just reach out to us. We're happy to help guide you. We have rates for all of the ships, so that's easy for us to do. So, Johnny, I think that's the end of our presentation today.
We have just to...
Sorry, Johnny. We just want to cheers with all of you, okay? I'm very sorry. It will be virtually, not personally, but we hope to welcome you in Sorrento very soon.
Maria Rosario, thank you.
This experience, beautiful experience on board.
Okay. Thank you. Yeah, you should enjoy. Yeah, good. Glad to see that you're not wasting the bottle of Prosecco.
Cheers.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
It was really wonderful.
Thank you, Maria Rosaria. Thank you to Vittorio, the owner. Thank you to
the I can smell it and I can taste all of that delicious food. I'm sure we all want to be there.
And also to Susan, thank you very much for your help. You have been great. Thank you again for your help to present the presentation of Oplontis.
And we have a prize, Johnny.
Yeah, the prize, we will give a $200-$300 coupon to the first one goes to Lindsay Harrison of Academy Cruise, and the second one goes to Elizabeth Culligan of Sundial Travel. Thank you very much for you again to participate, and don't forget that tomorrow we will be on another beautiful coast, which is the Antibes and Juan-les-Pins in France. So register on our webinar for tomorrow, always at noon. Thank you very much again to Naples and all our friends over there, and Jessica and everybody else. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Bye.
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 Bye. Bye.
So good to see you all.
Bye.
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 Bye. Bye, Jessica.
Thank you.
Ciao.
We're going to come back, okay?